Health is about more than access to care. As important as health coverage is and excellent care is, there's more to our health than health care. Our family history and genetics, our personal behaviors, the social and environmental factors that shape our choices and shape our behaviors, those are the powerful things that drive our health day to day. If you're a healthy person, Kaiser Permanente may see you 15 minutes a year, maybe a half an hour, and have a lot of electronic contact with you. If you're not healthy, we may see you for a week during the year. But most of your time is spent in other places, in your home, in your workplace, in your school, the places where you worship and play and learn and work. That's where your health is shaped. Tobacco, poor diet, physical inactivity, alcohol consumption, those are the things that are really driving death and premature death. And in many ways, they represent the defaults in our behaviors. Defaults meaning not bad things, defaults meaning this is where we go under stress, under pressure, if nothing's moving us positively in another direction. Screen time, eating, not being physically active, the abuse of alcohol, smoking, salt. What we need at this point in time is a fully integrated approach to four categories of disease that are driven by four modifiable risk factors. Unhealthy diet, inactivity, any use of tobacco, the harmful use of alcohol, those four factors are driving the burden of disease and premature death in four major categories that occupy perhaps 80% of chronic disease and 80% of the costs we experience in our healthcare system and 80% of the tremendous burden on individuals and families from cardiovascular disease, from diabetes, from chronic respiratory disease, and from a number of cancers. This is more data from Kaiser Permanente. We have right now nearly 500,000 diabetics in our population of 9 million members. That costs about $3.5 billion a year. That's what it costs their employers, that's what it costs them, and there is the burden of diabetes on them and their families. But the bottom part of the iceberg that we don't even see are pre-diabetics. For us, there are getting close to 1 million pre-diabetics, half of whom in the next 10 years will become diabetic if we don't do something to interrupt the course that they're on. And I can assure you that there is no insurance company, there is no government organization, there is no business that has factored in the full impact of this coming storm into their business plans for the next 10 years. It's always puzzled me that we talk about those four major categories of disease as non-communicable disease. Everybody from WHO to the United Nations calls those non-communicable diseases. They're not non-communicable diseases. They are communicable diseases. They are a social phenomenon. They are rooted not just in individual behavior, but what surrounds us, in our families, in our friends, in the people we work with, the people we're associated with. And those communicable social factors can either drive toward illness and disability, or they can drive toward health if we organize them that way. Failure to act is not an option for us. We have to begin to think about what we do in health and healthcare and in other fields in a very different way, rather than thinking, as we always talk about, focusing on our core business, keeping focus on our core business. We have to inventory all the assets we have within our control and think about how all of those assets can be deployed in a much more powerful, linked, and integrated way to create change and to surround people with total health. There is a science to it. There is evidence to it, and there is practice to follow in order to achieve those results. But it has to be comprehensive. It has to start with engaging people on their terms, understanding them, how they think and work and are wired, guiding them, connecting them, surrounding them with other people who can support them and who are like them, making it simple, creating circumstances where they are gratified and feel the results of progress, and at the same time, changing systematically the environments in which all of us live that shape our changes in behavior so that those can help direct us and support us in a positive direction.